Hi sir, I'm fine, thanks a lot. So it's been 11 days. Yeah. So the pain part is gone now, finally.
So Pulkit has done the process just 10 days back. Today is 11th day. He has come for a normal visit where I have examined his implanted site, both the frontal aspect and the crown area. Looks good. The hairs have started growing. Minor scabs are there, which will eventually fall off once he starts a little shampooing in a little more vigorous way, and is using some moisturizers also to heal the implanted site and even the donor area. Yes, Pulkit, so if you have any relevant questions.
Yeah, sir, I want to know like what exactly is after treatment now, yes. After 10 days, what all I need to follow?
Yes.
In terms of any medication, in terms of any lotions I have to use. And by the way, I am allergic to minoxidil, so please keep that in mind before referring anything.
Sure, okay. So basically, we introduce topical minoxidil or oral minoxidil or topical hair serums like herbal peptides, decapeptide or tetrapeptide hair serums onto the implanted site and also the existing hairs after 15th day post hair transplant. So as Pulkit is allergic to topical minoxidil, which many people are, so we are switching him to oral minoxidil and we'll see the response. 2.5 mg oral minoxidil at night time is what I'm prescribing for him. And in spite of topical minoxidil, I have given him herbal peptides containing procapil, capexil, redensil combination, etc.
I have one question, sir. Is there any side effects of these medications as far as this oral minoxidil is concerned, because I am not sure about it till now. Yeah. Since I have only seen 2% and 5% of the minoxidil which are usually available. So if you can explain a little bit more about it.
Topical minoxidil counts as 2%, which is mainly prescribed for female pattern hair loss, 5% which is usually prescribed for regular male pattern hair loss and post hair transplant also. There is something called 7.5 and 10% as well. But we reckon only to prescribe up to 5% topical. The oral minoxidil is a recent introduction worldwide since 2 years, which is quite safe if we use it around 2.5 to 5 mg dose. So which is quite safe as a counterpart of topical minoxidil. Oral minoxidil was earlier introduced to prevent hypertension or increased BP. But scientists found that increased the hair regrowth. So oral minoxidil is still under US FDA jurisdiction, but doctors are using it and is finding safe to use for patients on oral minoxidil who are allergic to topical minoxidil.
Sir, one last question about the shampoo. Which shampoo I have to use after this baby shampoo?
Yes, after we have given him a baby shampoo, hydrolyzed keratin baby shampoo post hair transplant, we prescribe to each and every hair transplant patients. After a month, I will give you peptide based and caffeine based hair shampoo, which is sulfate, sulfonates and paraben free, so that it doesn't get any allergy and the hairs grow well with that. And I think you were supposed to, you were concerned about the oral finasteride post hair.
Oh yes, I was about to ask.
Yes.
So see sir, my question is, these days we are absolutely so much influenced by the internet these days. So the moment we see something on like Google or whatever, we try to search all these medicines. So when I search this particular medicine, it has many side effects. So if you can elaborate more on the same, and do I have to worry about it?
Okay. This is a nice question to ask, and everyone should ask to a trichologist of theirs. So that oral finasteride or oral deuterostride comes under 5 alpha reductase inhibitors, which are male hormone DHT blockers basically. It directly doesn't lower your male hormone DHT. What it essentially does is blocks the effect of the receptor level. So the hormone is there, the DHT hormone is there in your blood and also on your scalp, but it will not thin out your thick follicles because the receptor we are blocking through by giving oral finasteride or oral deuterostride. So oral finasteride is basically a safe US FDA approved tablet for male pattern hair loss. So yes, but less than 2% cases has reported some kind of side effects, which are mainly sexual dysfunction, which starts with little loss of libido or erection issues, and penile nocturnal tumescence we call it, that gets delayed. So these are the initial side effects of finasteride, And there are more psychological side effects as people are going to internet and reading more and more about it. So we call it the post-finasteride era syndrome era we are living in. It's not, it's a very safe drug. It is still the USFDA approved drug. Lakhs and lakhs of patients were prescribed. And touch wood, I have not seen a single very severe side effect out of it. I don't prescribe the oral finasteride for long. I prescribe for 3 months, 6 months initially. See the thing. Watch out for any kind of side effects. I ask the clients, please let us know if you find any kind of side effects. And more importantly, if a patient stops the oral finasteride, if he sees some kind of side effects, first like loss of libido, the side effects goes away in 4 to 6 weeks time frame once you stop the drug.
Sure. Thanks, sir. Thanks a lot. Thank you so much.
So I think we are done with the post-op instructions. This is the primarily after 15 days topical or oral minoxidil, topical hair serums, oral biotin, amino acids, protein supplements. Then if somebody is deficient in vitamin D, B12, we supplement that. Oral finasteride or oral dutasteride and low level laser therapy comb post hair transplant helps in the regrowth of hairs. And subsequently he will be coming for injections of growth factor concentrate therapy sessions, which is like advanced PRP to enhance his existing hair growth, and we are looking forward best results for him.
Thanks, okay. Thank you so much.
Okay, thanks.